we present G.F. Newman's The Corrupted, Episode 1. That's what I want.
1991 started badly for me. It was like I was thrown back to square one. My 30-year sentence starting over down on the Isle of Wight. Not that I was seeing much of the prison or the seaside banged up from behind my door. The authorities were terrified I'd foment trouble here, after being caught raping Leah Cohen in my cell at the prison in Devon. It wasn't rape, we'd been blissfully making love. When the screws threw open the door, I pretended to be throttling and raping her. I was ghosted to the island. I don't know what happened to Leah, or Dr. Elizabeth Langham, as she now was. Well, there were no visitors, so no word from Mum, or about her divorce from Joey, Sir Joseph. The only news I got is what the screws fed me in the yard during exercise. They weren't very forthcoming, and none of it cheerful. A war with Saddam Hussein in Iraq after he attacked Kuwait's oil fields. The IRA launching mortars at Downing Street from a van in Whitehall, and almost getting the new Prime Minister, John Major, in his cabinet. The Soviet Union in chaos and breaking up, with drunks or madmen in charge of the nuclear arsenal. The world going up in a nuclear flash would make not much difference to me. My world, made tolerable by Leah Cohen, was gone, and I was powerless to do anything about it. Now, none of this boded well for a peaceful coexistence at Parkhurst. I planned on causing trouble when I got out on the wing proper. There I go, getting ahead of myself again.
Stand off that bed for the Assistant Governor, Oldman.
What's the point of that? He can sit down for me if he wants.
Still determined to be a troublemaker, are you, Mr. Oldman?
I'm only being what you make me, Mr. Ryan. I've done 9 years as an innocent man and got knocked back 3 because I appealed. What do you expect me to do? Quietly play with my piddler?
If you're tough, believe me, I'm tougher. I started on the floor like Mr. Peters here 10 years ago. I've been abused, pissed on, shat on, punched. Oh, and stabbed. But here I am still.
I'll ask the Queen to give you a medal for endurance, shall I?
Oh, that'd be nice. Tell her I'll take it too.
She might give him one, Governor, for being such a bollockhead.
We've had harder prisoners, Mr. Peters. They all crack and cry their hearts out.
What's the purpose of this visit, Mr. Ryan?
We've had another request for a visiting order from your mother.
She what? Can she come?
Oh, we won't allow any visitors until there's a marked change in your attitude.
Oh, come on, Mr. Ryan.
It's up to you, Mr. Holman.
I will change, you see. Look, what happened to Dr. Langham? Is she all right?
Oh, that were a quick change. Rapist to welfare officer without even drawing breath.
I shouldn't have done it. I couldn't help myself.
If you show such dramatic recognition about your original offence, I'm sure you'll make excellent progress.
You know the score there, Governor.
You're nothing if not persistent, Mr. Oldman. As you're so concerned, Dr. Langham's up for adjudication. You might cost her a job.
I think I'm more nervous than you, Leah. Are you sure you don't want my solicitor to go with you?
Oh, I'm sure, Catherine. It would seem like I've got something to hide. Yeah. The committee decides my competence as a psychiatrist, letting a prisoner get the better of me. Anyway, you can't afford another solicitor's bill.
Kevin Wheeler thinks Joey's trying to run me out of money over our divorce. He's succeeding as well. I'll have to get myself a little job.
You probably don't want to hear this, but your husband displays all the hallmarks of a psychopath.
There was a time I didn't want to hear it. I trusted him. It took a long while for the penny to drop over what he did to Brian. I knew Joey instructed that arsonist to burn those houses in Gloucester Road. I kept telling myself no. He couldn't be so wicked.
Well, psychopaths have no sense of their wickedness. Or they find ways to justify it to themselves, believing it's for the greater good.
I keep praying he somehow trips himself up and Brian is set free. I'm finding it harder and harder to believe that.
I know it's difficult, Catherine, but we mustn't lose hope.
I would if it wasn't for you. Now, are you sure you don't want me to come with you for support?
I'll be fine. Wouldn't look right if anyone saw me with the mother of the supposed rapist.
Let me know straight away how you get on. I'll be on tenterhooks.
I promise.
Dr. Langham, would you like to come in? This is Dr. Aziz and Dr. Eves.
Do have a seat, Doctor. This is not the Star Chamber. This is a review of your recent actions in view of the tragic circumstances you found yourself in at Channing Wood Prison. Regrettably, the prison authorities didn't provide better protection.
Well, that's difficult to achieve in one-to-one sessions with clients.
Even when they are convicted murderers who have proved disruptive?
There is a history to his disruptive behaviour, Dr. Eves.
Dr. Rickard, the psychiatrist at Broadmoor, says the belief at the root of his disruptive behaviour is delusional. Oldman imagines the MP, Sir Joseph Olinska, to be the perpetrator who ordered the houses to be set alight where a mother and her three children burned to death.
At a glance, it would appear to be a delusional belief.
You looked closer than Dr. Rickard and came to an entirely different diagnosis?
Yes, I did.
Which resulted in your being raped in Brian Oldman's cell. That hardly supports your conclusion that this is an innocent man wrongly accused. Well, Doctor?
I don't believe the two are related. I believe I managed the patient in a way that caused him to overstep the mark.
Is this why you refused to press charges for rape?
I thought it would be inappropriate and highly damaging to the patient to do so.
That wouldn't be because you'd had a different sort of relationship with the prisoner when he was a younger man.
I was quite candid about my earlier relationship with Mr. Oldman from the start of my doctor-patient relationship with him in prison.
Did that relationship in any way cloud your judgment? I'm thinking of the report you wrote.
I tried to remain objective. What did impress me about Mr. Oldman was the conviction of his innocence. The more sessions I had with him, the more convinced I became.
Do you still hold that view, Doctor, post-rape?
That incident didn't change my initial opinion.
Your report to the Home Office seems far from objective, Doctor. One might conclude from it that you have lost your sense of medical perspective. I quote, "This is an innocent man who I believe is suffering enormous deprivation and abuse by prison officers in the system."
I was shocked by what I heard.
You chose to believe what you heard? As a prison department psychiatrist, did you not feel you were betraying your colleagues with such a statement?
I felt the need to show the situation as I saw it. Colleagues or not, I think that was borne out at Brian's Mr. Oldman's trial for killing an officer who was sexually abusing him.
You stated the situation. You offered no evidence in support of your argument.
In fairness to Dr. Langham, Allison, she is a psychiatrist, not a detective.
Your report was forensically constructed. I congratulate you.
Thank you.
Tell me, Doctor, are you in love with Brian Oldman?
Dr. Eves, I don't feel that's an appropriate question to put to Dr. Langham. You needn't answer, Dr. Langham, unless you wish to.
Oh, that's perfectly all right. I will answer. I'm never quite sure what love is. It seems to me to be a set of sensations, mostly sexual, that completely scramble logic and objectivity, rendering any witness so affected and quite unfit for purpose. I greatly admired Mr. Oldman for his tenacity and persistence naming Sir Joseph Olinska the real perpetrator of the crime for which he was convicted. I believe it's a double injustice that he is punished further for remaining consistent. It's my firm opinion that he isn't deluded in his belief.
Are there any further questions for Dr. Langham? Dr. Eves?
Is it appropriate that Sir Joseph Olinska should be persecuted when another man was fairly convicted for the crime?
With respect, Dr. Eves, I could guide you to many miscarriages of justice where the wrong man or men have been convicted by overzealous or misinformed police officers. Many languished for years in prison, like Brian Oldman, before the truth finally came out.
With someone in such a social station as Sir Joseph being suggested to take the place of the convicted man.
Status or social prominence does not exculpate the real offender.
Tell me, Doctor, would it be your intention to continue seeing Mr. Oldman as a patient in Parkhurst Prison?
Parkhurst doesn't fall within my area. However, were it to, I would endeavour to make a case for our sessions to continue, perhaps in a more open environment, should this committee find that my early conduct was appropriate.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.